And welcome back. This is the RPG Check. We have made some changes, finally. First of all, you notice inventory is a lot spiffier now. Still got a lot of scrolls, and I let Durance have all the traps. I've grouped them together. But what's really noticeable is all the spell tones are missing. I figured out what to do with all these. Just memorize the spells off them and throw out the rest, and maybe keep an extra spell tome to switch between as a skill or something like that. Or an ability to switch spell tomes. If you wanted to, we could do that. Yeah, so he knows a lot of new spells now. We didn't even have Slicken. So yeah, put these in our book, but we haven't rested yet, so I don't think we know this stuff. Yeah, so it highlights the ones we have. Ghost Blades. Looks sounds pretty neat. Immediate pierce damage and a hobbled affliction on targets. Because they're not hobbled for long, but it's a first level spell, so. Combusting Wounds, I believe we already had. Fetid Caress. Target becomes paralyzed, afflicted with boiling pustules of foul-smelling liquid that erupt from their skin, sickening those nearby. So, you're paralyzed for 10 seconds, and then AoE sickened for almost 8 seconds. Well, I'm hoping, you know, it looks like it would be AoE for anybody, so we gotta watch out not to sicken our party members. We have a Rolling Flame, Rebounding Ball of Fire, inflicting burn damage. Did I? Yeah, that's that. So I put some of these into our book, so when we rest next time, we'll have them. Unless we have them now. I don't know. This isn't like D&D. Gotta keep reminding myself. We do have them now, don't we? So that's 2 and then 3. Kalakos Minor Blights. Creates a ball of energy that can be thrown at an enemy, causing burn, freeze, corrode, or shock damage. Blights are continuously replenished until the spell ends. Now, I don't know exactly how that works, if it's just random, the game decides. I'm not sure. Kinda looks like we have Slicken now, and that now, but we don't have... Well, because it's combat only, that's why. That's why it's grayed out. Dimensional Shift switches the locations of the caster and one ally, leaving a shockwave between them that stuns all caught in a line of fire. So stunned for 6.5 seconds versus fortitude. They're stunned, they're not... It's no damage, unfortunately. So most probably these are things I'll play around with now and then stop. Wall of Force, I think we already had that in Rhinegrim's we had. That might be new. Blast of Frost. No uses left. Oh no, we had Blast of Frost. Okay. Okay, so that's that. And more importantly...
Yes?
Kana. I found out what to do with him. You know we picked him up in episode 30-something. And, sorry guys, I have something in my teeth. Only now, in episode 172, 173, I'm not sure what we're on, I'm finally learning how to use his chants. That's horrible. That really is horrible. So it's edit chants is what you want to go into. I had this all blank, and I was trying to interface with this to, like, put spells up in there or something. Not the way it works. So, you put the spells in here, so I've renamed them. Every time you go, you know, you'll get another. Like if I start adding things here, it'll change the chant 3, but I've changed the name to offensive and defensive. Now these offensive spells, he would begin chanting, you know, with this, the Dragon Thrash to Dragon Wailed, which is 66.1 burn damage over 13.8 seconds, and 66.1 slash damage over the same amount of seconds. Generates a hazard field, causing burn and slash damage to enemies in the area of effect. Now, in effect, I've been handicapping myself by not using this stuff, so combats are going to become easier now, you know. I've yet to use this, you know, in action, but think I've got to figure it out. So we got that, and then we got the offensive rear Rime and Frost. It drops a Rime and Frost trap for a little over 10 seconds, leaves a hazardous trail of frost wherever they move, hobbling and causing freeze damage to enemies. So it'll be the same as the Rime and Frost trap, which is, I'm sure I have it. Freezing Pillar. We don't have that trap. Okay. Can't believe I thought we had every trap there could be. Okay. So there's that. Oh wait, we go this way. Alright. Yeah, it throws it because we start this way, and then we... Okay, and then it goes to, lo, their endless host, the Harbinger's Doom. Generates a field of terror, frightening enemies. And you have effect, I need a drink. So, about 6 seconds, and it has this linger thing, and it frightens. Resolve dexterity reduced by 2 and accuracy is reduced by 10. So they hit for crap, and resolve and dex go down a little bit. Now what's interesting is this is the linger effect. If you see, its duration is 8.0 seconds and linger 5.8 seconds. So, these effects are active both at once. Pretty neat. So that's the offensive, which is what I'm going to be using most often, most probably. Defensive is if we're getting our butts whooped, and it's easier to help yourself than to damage enemies, because they get, you know, generally speaking, they get saves, you know. So if they make their saves, then you're chanting and nothing's happening, you know. So I'd save this for defensive. This emboldens area allies in the area of effect, giving bonuses to fortitude and will. So plus 10 fortitude, plus 10 will. And this is plus 1.2 move speed, but I really like it for the plus 10 reflex. Increases the movement rate and reflex of all allies in the area of effect. And then ends with 1 dozen stowed against the power of the saint. Plus 10 defense against frightened attacks, minus 10 seconds for frightened duration, and then the same for terrified attacks and duration. So yeah, decreases duration of and defense against frightened and terrified effects. So, and these are, you know, because we have 3 of them, so I made a defensive and an offensive. So, and the neat thing is, he starts chanting these, which they're actually called, this is a phrase. So, well, that's a phrase, and this is a collection of phrases. Okay, so these are phrases, and these are chants. Okay, got it. Just using the wrong terminology. So, once he's got a certain amount of phrases chanted, he goes out casting this stuff. -5 damage reduction. Taking away summoner damage reduction. Summoning 3 skeletons. So these are in effect, there are spells that he can use. Thunderous explosion that stuns and shoves enemies. 14 to 21 crush and stun for 7.3 seconds. And then we got level 2. Conjures 3 worms into existence to fight for the party. Lasts for 25 seconds. Or until destroyed, obviously. So, and here's my offensive and my defensive right here. And I'll actually list there for you. And done looking here. Okay. Amasses stray soul fragments to form 2 will-o-wisps to fight for the party. So summons 2 will-o-wisps. And this one is really awesome. Calls down a drake from the skies to fight for the party. Now I'm assuming the drake, you know, breathes fire, obviously. Hopefully he won't hurt the allies. Because they are area spells, I believe. Well, area blasts. So that's that. So we can, once he chants 3 phrases, this will go up to 3, or, well, whatever we need it to be. This will require 5. So once this gets to 5, boom, I can summon that.
Yeah.
Yeah. So pretty awesome. So things are going to get a little easier now that we're using our chanter to his best ability. And, you know, aside from actual casting of the spell, he can keep, you know, hitting people the entire time.
No problem.
These guys are talking about something, I don't know. All of the Anamphatha have called upon the Ethic Gnoll for war paint at some point. They say the Ethic Gnoll first learned to make war paint in the White March and were banished for it. Don't worry, Estremor. All who make sacrifices here do so willingly.
Quickly and quietly.
As long as they do, I don't have a problem. If I come across somebody who's being sacrificed against their will, there's gonna be problems. I'm only sneaking to find secrets. Guess I haven't been here. It actually shows him on the map? Or is that something else I'm looking at? Yeah, you can see him on the map. It's pretty awesome. The chanter says nothing. I'm kind of hoping I won't get into a battle with these guys. But I have a feeling we're going to find something that we're not going to be happy about. An opal. And 32 gold. Was that main chamber? No, it isn't. That's the main chamber. But we've been there. Alright, so
I shall be discreet.
So I'm really glad we figured that out. What is that? Oh, Svef? Yeah, keep that. Not worth the risk. There are still rites to be performed at the main altar. If you wish to observe, we only ask that you remain silent. Eventually. I'm actually going to explore this entire place before I go here. Oh, Keeper Worda. Are you a man of your Worda? Copper, right? Not taking that.
Builder's wisdom to you.
The elderly dwarf blinks at you, not quite looking at you. Her eyes are pale and clouded with cataracts. Welcome to the Blood Sands. It is rare that an Estremor sets foot in these caverns. Her sightless eyes fix on you as she tilts her head. What brings you here, I wonder? Tell me about Blood Sands. This is the raw, bloody heart of Ir Glanfath, where some come to give their essence back to their people. Her dry lips bend into a sardonic grin, where others seek a noble escape from their trials. The legacy of the builders to the tribes was not merely Adra and stone, but a sense of community, and it is here that Glanfathans come to sacrifice what is most precious, even their own lives, to preserve it. Something more? Yes, what do you do here? I sell and maintain certain goods for the preservation of our order, and I perform some of our ritual sacrifices. How do these sacrifices work? Like any worthwhile ritual, it's too complex to explain in detail. It involves clotting the supplicant's essence, binding it to their life's blood, and drawing it into a container or vessel. I'd like to see what you have for sale. Oh, you don't have that much. And we don't even use the potions we have, hardly ever. Thank you. We'll go up here. Looked like he was scratching his butt for a second. Hail, Earthblight. Chanters. The chanter grunts a long, low syllable that echoes through the cave. The silent chanter eyes you steadily. Have you come to give of yourself, elf? You may seek out any of our order within the sacrificial chambers. No, that's quite all right. The bravest sons and daughters fell not by the swords of Estermorin, but by the daggers of their brethren. I'm gonna leave that. I'll have to look at. Yeah, we'll go right up here.
I'll see what I can find.
Oh, is this a main chamber as well? Blood sacrifice chamber, fire sacrifice chamber. Alright, well, let's check out the blood sacrifice one, I guess. It says nothing. There is no greater honor than dying for one's tribe. If some fall in battle, how is this different?
As your blood flows, so shall your essence. Your life's energy shall feed the soil, and your soul's energy shall enrich the community. This is by your own choosing, supplicant.
Archdruid Reston. A dwarven man stands on a raised platform. Beneath him, an elf lies prone on a stone table. As you get closer, you hear the dwarf speak in a gravelly monotone. And then he says that, and then... Yes, the elf's tone is high but even. The dwarf grips a hatchet with both hands and raises it over his head. He throws his shoulders forward and swings the weapon into the elf's chest, connecting with a meaty thump. Blood gushes around the blade and the sacrifice's screams rend the air. Sheesh. Aloth's lips curl with disgust. This is why I prefer the wand to the blade. Despite his earlier agreement, the elf thrashes upon the stone table, his torso arching while his arms and legs remain tied in place. Meanwhile, the dwarf spreads his arms wide and allows blood to spatter his robes. When the elf is finally silent and still, the dwarf pulls his hatchet from the body and wipes it on his hem. Kana makes a disgusted noise and turns away. I think I prefer those rites when they were only a mere words on a page. Why did I look? It's not as if I didn't expect it. Streaks of red-brown blood and gobs of tissue have worked themselves into the minute grooves of the stone. Archdruid Reston. The dwarf wears crimson robes that are stained and streaked with dark patches. Gee, I wonder how that happened. His face is smooth, but lacking youthful elasticity. It is as if the lines and wrinkles have been formed and erased many times over. Really? They're getting power from this essence? He watches you with eyes like two black pits as he wipes his hatchet on his robes. Hail, Estermore.
No one comes to Blood Sands without a purpose. What is yours?
His voice is deep and rough-edged. It echoes like a river in an ancient cave. I didn't hear any river echoing cave thing. Tell me more about the Ethic Knoll. We are a druidic order that has been in Twin Elms since Anguithan times. Our founders came from the White March seeking a place where we might practice our beliefs in peace, as it were. Unlike most of the Glamfellen brethren, we seek answers in the world around us rather than in the teachings of the gods. We believe that all life has power and that this power can be siphoned and conducted. We are not, as some suggest, madmen and murderers. All of our rituals are conducted with willing participants and through methods that have been tested and refined over centuries. He nods, his black eyes shining. This allows us to create the war paint for which we are respected, if not loved. What's war paint? A special unguent binding raw essence to the wearer. It grants incredible advantages in combat and has made us indispensable to the tribes. Whatever they say about our practices, almost all of them have made use of our war paint at some time or another. A slow smile spreads across his face. Fascinating indeed how the most strident objections can be overcome by circumstance. How are you different from the Ovates of the Golden Grove? A dry laugh rasps from his throat. Golden Grove. I remember when Arona came up with that name. He gives you a darkly gleeful look. Used to be as green as the rest of the forest, you know. We're more similar than they'd like to admit. We both believe in achieving power without the double-edged aid of the gods. But their fantasy is pure creation, something from nothing. They blind themselves to the fact that all life, the mightiest dragon to the slimmest blade of grass, requires death, and the greatest ends require the greatest sacrifice. An interesting thought. I'll have to ponder it further. A wise enough sentiment. I want to know more about your sacrifices. A guttural laugh rumbles from his throat. We merely believe that, in giving up something of value, the energy from that sacrifice can be diverted elsewhere. It is not so different from what folk practice all over the world. If you want to turn the soil, sail a ship, or move a cart, you must expend energy. He smooths his robes. But we're best known for our practice of kith sacrifice. This is the most potent form of sacrifice because it releases the most energy. We distill the essence of an entire soul into raw power that can strengthen the body, fortify the soul, and extend life. Kana squirms. More than a little different from sailing a ship. An interesting perspective, even so. The Glamfellens are never half-hearted in their superstitions, are they? I'd like to buy war paint. I am no merchant elf, Talk to Keeper Werda. She's around here somewhere. Yeah, that's all I wanted to know. Restlin's eerily smooth face is motionless as he watches you. And who are you?
I am the Archdruid of the Ethic Knoll. For centuries it has been my duty to guide our rituals and guard our knowledge. It is work that requires a certain resilience, but it is not without its benefits.
Stupid to say so now, but I wonder what he'll say. You murdered a man right here. He lowers his head. Your simplistic morals do not apply here, Estremor. Murder does not enter into it.
It was a sacrifice, and one willingly entered into. The survival of all things depends on balance. Give and take.
The smooth skin at the corners of his mouth and eyes wrinkles for one brief instant. The principle lies at the heart of all power. Expending something of value releases energy. Energy that can be channeled by those who know how. He tilts his head toward you. All Kith, whether or not they care to admit it, practice this. We take the yield of the land and the flesh of beasts to live, and we give our blood and sweat to propagate the things we desire. I can see what you mean. Then you're wiser than most. I like the attack option. There is much power in the world for those who have the will and the knowledge to tap into it. His black eyes dance. I invite you to explore our halls and speak with our supplicants. One can learn much by observing the sacrifices others are willing to make for a greater purpose. Perhaps you will even consider making a sacrifice of your own. No. He opens one hand toward you. The creases and nails are darkened and brown. Not all of our sacrifices are written in blood, but the most powerful are. Farewell. Something over here. Let's see what's in there. Yeah, a bunch of copper. So I want to look over in this direction before I go to the fire sacrifice chamber. Blood and fire. No, there's no way we can open that with him standing there. Opal. Or two opals, actually. The gift of sacrifice transmutes blood into water and essence into power. Just as the flesh of one nourishes many, the sacrifice freely made strengthens those that will come to us. Strength. For the ones that will come to us. The silent chanter eyes you steadily. So this one says nothing. That one's a low hum. Keeper. Greatness requires sacrifice. These halls are not for the weak of spirit. The blood of sacrifice waters the soul of your Glanfath. Just a regular hunting bow and 720 copper. Alright, let's head to the fire sacrifice, because I think we've seen everything else. Looks like. There are still rites to be performed at the main altar if you wish to observe. We only ask that you remain silent. Well, this isn't the main altar. They say the Ithic Noel first learned to make war paint in the White March and were banished for it. The heat emanating from this pool threatens to singe the flesh of your face.
Slowly now.
A greater flame blight. There's nothing else to see around here. Are we done in here? This is nothing for us to do. Is that the main chamber? That's the sacrifice. Let's just run over here real quick. No, I've seen that. Alright. I guess we're leaving? I guess we're done? Figure we're gonna find out something shocking. We've talked to him before, right? Keep a Garast watch as you approach without betraying any emotion. Be welcome, Estremore. Yeah, we've talked to him. Alright, I guess we're done. And we didn't even have a quest or anything to do in there. Okay, so the only place we haven't explored here is Tir Evron. And we'll go to commune with the gods and get their help for fighting Theos. Well, Theos, actually. Thanks for watching. See you next time and endure. In it during, grow strong.